Good morning. Today is May 14th. Happy Older Americans Month to one and all.
Thank you.
Welcome to the third meeting of the Aging Committee for 2024. State Senator Cordell Clear, and I'm honored to chair the committee. Fellow members of the committee include Senator Rachel May, Senator Jabari Christopher.
Good morning, Chair.
Good morning.
Senator Simca Felder, who's here. Senator Jose Serrano. Senator Rob Rollison, who's also here. And ranking member, Senator Jake Ashby. Thank you. If there are any additional comments that you'd like to make.
No, Madam Chair. Great morning. Thank you.
You're welcome. We'll begin consideration of the bills. Okay, I'm
going
to ask our committee director,
Chris LaBarge,
if a quorum is present.
Quorum is present,
sir. Thank you. The first bill on our agenda is Senate Bill 1491 by Senator Comrie.
Senate Bill 1491 by Senator Comrie, an act to amend the elder law in relation to creating and distributing a drug guide for senior consumers.
This bill, which has passed through committee and on the floor in prior legislative sessions, would require NYSOFA to create and distribute a prescription drug guide for seniors regarding drugs commonly used by people over 62 years of age. Such a guide would be a valuable resource for older New Yorkers who have multiple prescriptions and wish to remain informed of drug interactions, functions, and contraindications.
Move the bill.
Second.
Any questions? All right. Seeing none. We have a motion by Senator Ashby and seconded by
Senator Rollison.
Senator Rollison, okay. The bill has passed and is reported to the Finance Committee. All right. Second bill on our agenda is Senate Bill 1819 by Senator Stavisky.
Senate Bill 1819 by Senator Stavisky, an act to amend the real property tax law in relation to tax abatement for rent-controlled and rent-regulated property occupied by and real property owned by senior citizens or persons with disabilities.
This bill, which has passed through our Aging Committee and on the floor in 2021 and 2023, would increase the income eligibility limit for the senior citizens' rent increase exemption, SCRE, and Disability Rent Increase Exemption, DRE, programs by $5,000 to account for inflation. Are there any questions or comments?
Move the bill. Second.
Okay. We will now take a vote. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, nay. Are there any AWRs? Okay, the bill has passed and is reported to the floor. The third bill on our agenda is Senate Bill 7243 by Senator Hinchey.
Senate Bill 7243 by Senator Hinchey, an act to amend the elder law in relation to dementia care and to establishing the position of dementia care coordinator in the State Office for the Aging to manage the work of dementia care navigators and requiring each area agency to employ a dementia care navigator.
This bill aims to address our caregiver crisis in two ways. One, by establishing the statewide management position of dementia care coordinator in NYSOFA, and two, by requiring each local county aging office to have an individual dementia care coordinator to assist on the ground by empowering families, helping them to connect to local services and supports. Are there any questions or comments?
Move the bill. Second.
Okay. We will now take a vote. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Are there any AWRs? This bill has passed and is reported to the Finance Committee, and we have been joined by Senator Christopher, as promised. The fourth bill on our agenda is Senate Bill 8760 by Senator Clear.
Senate Bill 8760 by Senator Clear, an act to amend the elder law in relation to the automatic identification and enrollment of elderly pharmaceutical insurance coverage program enrollees in HEAP.
This bill, which is new for 2024 and strongly supported by AARP, provides that anyone who enrolls in the elderly pharmaceutical insurance coverage Epic low-cost prescription drug program shall have the option to automatically be enrolled in the home energy assistance program at the same time. It is estimated that it's up to 600,000 New Yorkers who are eligible for HEAP do not apply. Thus, this bill will help the program reach more seniors and ensure that they have crucial heating and cooling benefits. Are there any questions or comments? May I have a motion to move the bill?
Move the bill.
Second.
We will now take a vote. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Are there any AWRs? The bill is passed and is reported to the floor. The fifth bill on our agenda is Senate Bill 8865 by Senator Clear.
Senate Bill 8865 by Senator Clear, an act to amend the public health law in relation to quality improvement and increased consumer transparency in assisted living residences.
Assisted living residences are not federally regulated. Therefore, it is incumbent on the state to exact oversight over these facilities. This legislation does three main things. It requires increased reporting on quality measures, provides for the posting of information which would allow consumers to compare facilities, and establishes a rating system to develop quality measures. Are there any questions or comments?
Move the bill.
Second.
We will now take a vote. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Are there any AWRs? The bill is passed and is reported to the floor. The sixth bill on our agenda is Senate Bill 8893 by Senator Comrie.
Senate Bill 8893 by Senator Comrie, an act to amend the real property tax law in relation to providing an additional real property tax exemption for certain senior citizens.
This statewide bill allows localities the flexibility at local option to provide greater property tax relief to older New Yorkers with limited incomes by allowing exemptions of up to 65% of the assessed valuation of the underlying real property. Are there any questions or comments?
Move the bill.
Second.
We will now take a vote. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Nay. Are there any AWRs? The bill has passed and is reported to the floor. The seventh bill on our agenda is Senate Bill 8954 by Senator Clear.
Senate Bill 8954 by Senator Clear, an act to amend the real property tax law in relation to increasing the amount of income property owners may earn for the purpose of eligibility for the property tax exemption for persons 65 years of age or over.
This statewide bill allows all localities a local option to extend the senior real property tax exemption to those who have a total household income of up to $75,000. Right now, the cutoff is $50,000, which may have been reasonable at one time, but given inflation and the trajectory of property taxes, localities should have the power, once again, to help seniors stay in their long-time homes. Are there any questions or comments?
Move the bill.
Second.
We will now take a vote. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Are there any AWRs? The bill has passed and is reported to the floor. The eighth bill on our agenda is Senate Bill 9125 by Senator Clear.
Senate Bill 9125 by Senator Clear, an act to amend the public housing law in relation to requiring the Division of Housing and Community Renewal in collaboration with the New York State Office for the Aging to establish a publicly accessible online database of available senior housing units statewide and to amend the elder law in relation to requiring the New York State Office for the Aging to maintain the senior housing unit database.
So senior housing is very much needed in all parts of New York State. Thus, this bill directs the Division of Housing and Community Renewal in collaboration with the New York State Office for the Aging to establish the senior housing unit database to enable seniors in New York State to search for available housing units in a one-stop shopping fashion, making it easier for our seniors. Are there any questions or comments?
I don't think she, it's my wife, I don't think she agrees.
She doesn't.
Well,
good, she doesn't
have
a vote.
I'm sorry. We're equal now.
Yeah, we're equal.
Move the bill.
Seconded.
We will now take a vote. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Are there any AWRs? The bill is passed and it's reported to the Finance Committee. The ninth and final bill on our agenda is Senate Bill 9138 by Senator Clear.
Senate Bill 9138 by Senator Clear, an act to amend the elder law in relation to establishing the Interagency Elder Justice Task Force and providing for the repeal of such provisions upon expiration thereof.
This bill builds upon one of the proposals in the 2024 executive budget and the Senate One House budget with respect to the creation of an interagency elder justice task force. We add in specific language concerning legislative appointments and consultation with stakeholders. Are there any questions or comments?
Move the bill.
Second.
We will now take a vote. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Nay. Are there any AWRs? The bill is passed and is reported to the floor. We are now adjourned.